Oh, even experienced Dragon users can become better, a lot better, if they get some expert advice. So here we have someone to help us all improve our efficiency, Alexandria Carstens. She's a speech recognition consultant and trainer with Speakeasy Solutions, Inc. in Vancouver, British Columbia. Welcome back to RSI Help, Alexandria.
Thank you, Deborah.
Pleasure to have you back. Your number one tip is learning Dragon's built-in voice commands. Can you explain what they are and how they work?
Oh, there are numerous voice commands, and they usually involve interacting with the text that you've just dictated or actually performing functions on the computer itself. And it's not just a matter of being hands-free, it's actually more effective to use most voice commands for tasks that you do all the time.
So for example, if I dictated a book title, yes, and I wanted to italicize,
right,
I could command the book title and then italicize it?
Absolutely. And you chose an interesting example because it also comes down to using commands that are efficient, right? So just because the commands exist doesn't mean that they're all efficient. There's more than one way, for instance, to italicize a title. So you can do it in such a way that it's with one command with Dragon or several commands. So it's best to choose that one command that's the most efficient.
Save your voice.
Exactly.
So you also talk about using voice commands for editing.
Yes, editing is very important for most people who produce text. And I often see people grab the mouse and keyboard, and I have to explain to them that there are Dragon commands that can perform those same functions and faster. So learning editing commands as soon as possible really helps adoption of Dragon and prevents people from getting too frustrated.
And you say to run the microphone check. Can you explain what that is and how you do it?
Yeah, so the microphone check measures the pitch and volume of your voice compared to the background noise level. And this can change. So some days we wake up and we're boisterous and ready to go. And other days we wake up and we're sort of tired. So in those cases, Dragon will hear you different from the last time you ran the audio check.
So are you saying that Dragon knows your moods? Sensitive. It knows if you're kind of like feeling a little down or something.
Honestly,
it's a little like AI.
It is. One day, perhaps one day. But
does it tell you to feel better?
It'd be nice if it popped up and said, smile more. And which does actually help with your dictation. But anyway.
Smiling helps with your dictation?
Yeah. Because it just, it's relaxing.
Oh.
Right? It's a whole how you feel. And when you're angry, believe it or not, your dictation can go down the drain.
I always tell people that Dragon knows every bad word that exists. So if they say it, Dragon will accurately transcribe that. So watch out.
Don't dictate when you're
angry.
Angry. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So the microphone check, you want to run that whenever Dragon feels sluggish. It doesn't feel like it's responsive enough. And that is under audio. So for Dragon Professional, under audio, and then check microphone.
Okay, so moving right along, here's a tip that I need to do, and I confess I'm really bad at it. Correct.
Yes, it is so essential. It is the launch point for getting Dragon to learn your voice. Whether the word exists in the vocabulary or not, correcting appropriately, and there are a couple different ways to correct, but I try to focus on sort of the most efficient way to correct, which is literally saying correct followed by the word or words Dragon transcribed incorrectly. And then you'll have a menu pop up, and then choosing the appropriate one is so important. That takes care of most misrecognition issues. So that's critical.
I am so bad at Dragon. I'm just learning how bad I am at this.
Oh, no.
Okay.
No.
So tell us about the vocabulary editor and why you should use it.
The vocabulary editor is sort of the brain of Dragon. That is exactly where you can get what you want. And as I often say to my clients, if you don't get what you want with Dragon, we tend to stop using it, which of course, for those of us with RSI, that means more pain. So we don't want to do that. So learning to conquer the features in the vocabulary editor are really as essential as correcting. So correcting does most things, but it can't handle everything. And that's where the vocabulary editor picks up the rest of it through deleting words and through adding capitalized phrases as well as adding other phrases.
That sounds really useful.
Yeah.
And then you say you should export your Dragon profile on a regular basis.
Yes. Dragon has its own internal backup system, which doesn't always work. So you can either force a backup every once in a while, which is good. But if your user profile gets corrupt, which can happen, then Dragon will try and recover, but it doesn't always recover. So just to be on the safe side, I encourage everyone to always export a copy of their user profile. And you should put that on either a USB memory stick, on a server, in the cloud, anywhere other than your own computer. And if you can do that once a month, that is absolutely ideal.
Wonderful. And what are custom voice commands?
So custom voice commands pick up from where Dragon's built-in commands leave off. So an example would be in Microsoft Word, they don't have a command for highlighting text, you know, like in yellow or blue, whichever highlight color we choose. So that was one of the first commands that I made for both myself and my users was the ability to highlight text. So essentially, you're just filling in the gaps for the commands that Dragon does not have built into it, but more than that, personalized commands. So for instance, if you're sending an email to someone all the time, so for instance, with me, my business partner, Dean, I can just say new to Dean and it will immediately create a new email message, put in Dean's email address, go down to the subject, the whole nine yards. So Essentially, if something takes more than 4 to 5 mouse clicks and keystrokes and you do it all the time, create a custom command to do it for you. It'll be faster.
Like a macro.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And they're fun to make.
Well, that's really helpful. And what about using Dragon on the web? Can you do that?
You can. It's a little bit different. So it's a slightly different command set. There are built-in commands for using Dragon on the web. We do recommend Google Chrome is the most compatible, but also one of the fun things to do with the web are web searches by voice. So for instance, whether your browser's open or not, you could say, search Google for XYZ or search Bing for XYZ. So I could say, search Google for Deborah Quilter, and it will bring up the web browser and do a search on that and present you the results all with one command.
Auto formatting options.
Sure. So Dragon has different options available in it, regular options as well as auto formatting options. And with those options, they're not always the best for certain situations and people. So I recommend people understand what the options do, do a little bit of research and find out what options are best for them. So for instance, one thing I always ask users to turn off are the smart formatting rules. So those ones do not work as well as they should. I understand what the intent was, but it's more frustrating than anything else. I mean, as you say, when pop-ups just happen and you don't want them there, it can be frustrating.
Yes, it's like having the waiter come ask how your meal is just as you're at the critical point of the conversation. Yes.
Exactly.
Your advice for us?
Yeah, be kind to yourself. Take your time. Learning Dragon does not happen overnight. So take your time, learn it at your own pace and speed, but do practice regularly. It does happen. Eventually, you will be able to soar with the dragon.
And if you have what's the biggest mistake that people make with Dragon?
I even hesitate to say mistake, but one of the things that is often overlooked is actually hiring a Dragon trainer who can teach you the ins and outs of using Dragon. Either get you off on the right foot right from the beginning, so you learn the most powerful commands and the best methods for doing things with Dragon, or if you've been using Dragon for a while and you've been frustrated, there's information to be had, and consulting with a Dragon training professional really can fill in all those blanks and make such a huge difference.
I'm sure it's helpful in not getting bad habits deeply ingrained. I mean, I do typing technique retraining.
Yeah.
People have been typing the same way since they were in high school, and to untrain them is very arduous.
It is. It's very difficult. And it's the same thing with Dragon when you're just sort of teaching yourself and you come across a command that works, and suddenly you have no idea that there's a better command or a better way of doing things.
Yes. Thank you so much, Alexandria, for sharing all these wonderful tips with our viewers.
You're welcome.
Nice of you.
You're welcome. Thank you.